reorganizing what we have been describing so far, it is possible to explain the origin of the two names, pull and push. Pull logic ensures the availability of materials needed to complete the MPS by moving upstream one step at a time the information regarding the downstream requirements. In particular, replenishment orders at every stage are issued when the local stock gets too low. Replenishment orders contain the information which moves upstream only when there is a consumption at a downstream stage. The consumption is causing a reduction in stock, and the lower stock triggers a replenishment. For this reason, we can say that upstream replenishments are pulled by downstream consumption. Clearly, the pull logic constitutes the ground of the most diffused inventory management models, as the one illustrated in the previous lectures. Push logic ensures the availability of materials needed to complete the MPS by managing a sequence of production appointments. In particular, requirements of materials and components at every stage are calculated based on the MPS, bill of material, and stock availability data. The information referring to the whole production planning horizon is transferred at once to every production stage. Of course, purchase of materials and production of components do not start immediately. Purchase and production orders are time-phased, so that the materials from the upstream department will be in stock at the very moment in which they will be needed by the downstream stage. Should the upstream production be late, the downstream stage will delay activities with respect to its plan. For this reason, we can say the upstream replenishments are pushing downstream consumption. In this lecture, we discussed two logics which could be followed during the materials planning process: pull and push. Let's summarize the main differences, pros and cons, of the two logics. Pull logic only uses local and current information. Decisions are made based on what I see here and now, the current level of the local stock. Push logic uses information related to the whole production system along the whole planning horizon. Pull logic is simpler, but can work only if the following prerequisites are applicable: dependable replenishments, both in terms of quality and punctuality; stable demand. By definition, the pull logic implies a certain level of stock at every stage of the production process. Consequently, stock holding costs shall be reasonably low. On the contrary, push logic is more complex, yet it allows synchronization of replenishments and consumptions, which could theoretically lead to a zero stock situation. It must be said that, due to uncertainties characterizing every production system, the zero stock situation is still a chimera. A caveat: please notice that MPS data could be referred to either customer orders or demand forecasts. Sometimes push techniques are considered techniques in which production is based on orders, as opposed to pull, in which production is based on forecasts. In materials management, this is not true. Push techniques could be as well applied to forecast demand data. And actually, this is the most common case.